Welcome to Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Today's topic is Person of Unsound Mind. As in the previous video, we already studied about the capacity and incapacity of parties. Regarding doing a contract, according to Indian Contract Act. So in today's video, we'll discuss about the first point of capacity or incapacity of party, which is person of unsound mind. You can also watch these videos, other videos related to Indian Contract Act. Links are provided in the description box. So before I started the video, I want to say you that if you like my video, please like and share this video. And don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Now coming to the main topic, which is person of unsound mind. So what is the meaning of person of unsound mind? We'll discuss here firstly. So section 12 of Indian Contract Act defines a person is said to be sound mind for the purpose of making a contract if at the time when he makes it, he is capable of understanding it and of forming a rational judgment as to its effect upon his interest. To decide whether a person is of sound mind or not, we have to see two things. First is capacity to understand the contract, and second is ability to form a rational judgment as to its effect on the person's interest. So these are the two main factors to understand about the person is of sound mind or unsound mind, which is defined under section 12 of Indian Contract Act. Now we are discuss about the various features or various types of unsound mind persons, which are as follows. First is idiotic person, second is lunatic person, third is drunkard person. Basically this is also known as deficiency of mind. So first is idiot person. So what is the meaning of an idiot? An idiot is a person who is a natural fool or born fool. He is completely devoid of mental capacity. He cannot answer even the most simple questions put to him. His insanity is permanent. Therefore, a contract with an idiot is void. So, idiot person is fool by birth. He is completely devoid by mental capacity. So, that is the idiot person qualities. So, the contract done by idiot person is declared void. Second is lunatic person. A lunatic is a person whose mental power has deranged due to some mental strain. He is not a natural or born fool. Therefore, his incapacity is only temporary, and during lucid intervals, he is all right and can enter into a valid contract during that time. In case of lunacy, insanity is temporary. So what is a lunatic person meaning? He is deranged by his mental power due to some mental strain, but he is not fooled by birth. So the contract is declared void, but his incapacity is temporary. So when he becomes a sound mind person, he can do a contract at that time. Third is drunkard person or intoxicated persons. A drunkard is a person who is under the influence of drink or some drug. When he is drunk, he is incapable of making any rational judgment. Therefore, his case is treated as per with that of lunatic. He cannot contract so long as he is under the influence of drink or his drunkenness is not over. So drunkard person is not capable for doing a contract under the effect of drink. He can do the contract after the after removal of the effect of the drink. These are the types of person of unsound mind. I again repeat all the points so that you can easily understand about the topic. So what is unsound mind person? Basically the person who has capacity to understand the contract and ability to form a rational judgment to check the effect on person's interest are known as sound mind person. There are three types of unsound mind person, who is idiot, lunatic and drunkard. Idiot person is fooled by birth. He has no mental capacity by birth. So the contract done by idiot person is declared void. Second is lunatic. This person deranged his mental power due to some mental strain. He is not fooled by birth. So the lunacy is temporary. and the third is drunkard or intoxicated person. So the drunkard persons cannot do a contract under the effect of drink. So these are the types of person of unsound mind. If you have any questions about this topic, or if you want to know about any other topic related to research methodology, business management, business legislation, you can ask me through comment box. If you like my video, please like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. We'll meet in the next video with new topic. Thank you, everyone.